Previously on Blowout, Jonathan Anton's dream of opening a second hair salon in famed Beverly Hills is finally coming true.
This empty box is about ready to be turned into one of the greatest hair salons in the history of mankind. Welcome to Beverly Hills. You guys are coming with me.
Beverly Hills. Beverly Hills.
Honey, you are the first haircut at my BH shop.
But the road to success is never smooth.
Shut up. We got a major problem.
I can't send out an invitation that has InStyle's name on it,
yeah,
and then have everybody come and the salon not be open.
It will be done.
Will Jonathan Beverly Hills ever open its doors?
What's my shop gonna look like at 10 a.m. tomorrow morning?
Well, it's gonna look like it does right now.
It's your thing. Do what you wanna do. I can't tell you who to sock it to. It's your thing. Do what you wanna do. I can't tell you who to sock it to. If you want me to love you, maybe I'll wait. Believe me, woman, it ain't no big deal. Oh, you need love now, just as bad as I do. Makes me no difference now who you give your thing to. Oh, it's your thing.
It's your thing.
Do what you wanna do.
It's opening day for Jonathan's salon in Beverly Hills, except we're not open. I've been working all night, I'm exhausted, and we're scheduled to have an InStyle opening night party in 12 hours. The worst part of it all is that I feel like I've let everyone down, and I can't even face them. I just feel like I just didn't do my job.
We've got 3 white shampoo bowls and 3 Futura basic dryers.
Exactly.
And we got exactly what you wanted. We got white, and we got the silver dryers.
Great. Thank you so much.
I know the last time we met was kind of crazy.
All right.
And you've got, what, American Express?
Yeah.
Ooh. The lights! How fun.
I can't wait for my 9 o'clock to get here.
Totally hypothetically, you have a 9 o'clock and a 10 o'clock. What do you do?
Let's see if there's a phone. Call the West Hollywood salon and see what we can figure out.
Oh boy.
Can you get this party ready by 7:30?
We just spoke with the city of Beverly Hills inspector. And basically, in order for the guests to have a party here, he's got to give an approval. So he's actually planning on coming back through in the afternoon.
Give me a folder. Just tell me when I can't open it.
Okay. Okay, absolutely.
I'm just going to push you back to tomorrow.
You couldn't just do
that. All right? I'll call you in a little while.
Or should they come in and handle their books once they're here?
Probably, because Kimberly has the book.
Do you have your clients for today?
I'm full, yeah. You guys have the book, so I guess I'm just going to have to reschedule everybody.
Actually, you're more than welcome to use the West Hollywood salon.
Hey. This is a new space.
Shopping then, since we're already here in Beverly Hills.
All right, you guys, we have clients today that we're going to
Yeah.
Does everybody call them?
Do you know the phone number here, Annie?
I'm just going to book my clients in the West Hollywood location. I'm not just going to wait.
Did you want to reschedule? Did you want to come to the other place today, or do you want to just wait till tomorrow?
But the West Hollywood location, I can work out of there.
Yeah, you're on the book at 4 o'clock. The owner, like, Jonathan's like nowhere to be found, like doesn't even tell us anything. He's just walking around all upset and bitter, and it's like, that doesn't help anything at all.
We're gonna, Anybody who has clients is going to do them in the West Hollywood salon today. And then we're going to spend today just getting whatever together that we use. This is extra time to be even more prepared for tomorrow.
Right.
Okay. Can I give you a hug? I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
Salon owners gone through the same.
Is this the quickest way to thin out who your friends are?
Yeah, no kidding. How many hairstylists does it take to plug in a phone?
And three. Kimberly, can I? What do you need? I think we need the batteries.
Yeah.
Nice to meet you.
She has a 9 o'clock with Emily, and I kind of filled her in on a little bit what's going on.
Emily, you gotta call Emily. Can you call Emily?
I've already called Emily.
She already knows about this?
Yes.
And she is going to the other space?
Yes, she's going to West Hollywood.
She'll be in West Hollywood.
Do I need to go to the other one?
We just found this out, that this was in this condition.
Okay.
I'm so sorry.
So I show up here this morning, and they can't even do hair. The salon's a pit. So they're sending me to the other location, which I already called this morning, and no one bothered to tell me about, that, you know, I was going to have to go there instead. And they're paying for my parking. They're doing something, because this is out of control, you know? Like, I just don't even know what to do. And it's my birthday, and it's just not a good morning so far, and all I want to do is get a haircut.
I mean, what if my client shows up here? The last thing I want her to see is, like, an unfinished salon and somebody that's unfamiliar to her going, oh, he's not here.
Go ahead and go to the West Hollywood salon, or if they don't have clients, they can go ahead and head on home.
Okay, bye. Thanks for nothing.
In style.
Lots more important.
Yeah,
are we
more
having a party tonight?
I hope
okay.
so.
Right?
Yeah, what about the
party? Our opening party.
Just hang tight. I'm going to get it done. I've got about 5 more guys showing up, and I kind of need to get to work and help to finish the electrical.
Inspector's coming back at 4 o'clock. Will you give us a heads up if we need to call and do something about the party? I know you're trying to get it done, but I want just enough time to handle it.
Yeah.
Okay.
Absolutely. We got a bench. The salon might not be open today, but I have to be open for the in-style party tonight. I've invited the press and my clients and friends, and canceling now would be a disaster.
It's 11:30 now. So they're coming back at 2 for their first inspection. Right now, Jonathan's talking about maybe taking the party to the West Hollywood Salon.
That opens up a flood of other things.
Because we'd have to get the permits from the city of West Hollywood.
At the last minute, which they're tougher than Beverly Hills.
You'll have to change valet, the caterer. The caterer would have to find a location to be actually able to cook
over there. All the cars, all the guests.
Yeah. I think we should talk to him about the possibility that we're going to have to maybe move it to another night.
Station set up, like with products and ready to go, or all the stylists?
There's no stations yet. There's no products. There's no phones. There's cement and walls, and that's it.
We have 6 staff members standing by, and we're going to start making telephone calls to all the guests. And we believe that we should postpone the party versus moving it to West Hollywood.
All right, get out of your way.
I feel so nice and comfortable and safe here.
I just want to take a peek around and make sure that there's vacant enough stations for everybody who's working here to work.
Hi, did you find it? I'm glad you're here.
Yeah, I'm okay. I think they got us over here, I guess.
And it's, I think it's better if we're just here generating money, you know what I mean, while it's happening. I want to help him, you know, I'm sure he's stressing out right now.
I couldn't, he was like crying. I was like, okay, I can't handle this. I have to help. Like, I'm not doing anything today. I'm just helping you right now.
That's perfect.
Good.
I'm fine.
You're gonna hate me right now.
Oh no.
He's not there. He's at the nose shop.
Is he coming here?
Not today. And I was just gonna call you because I just got off the phone with him to remind him to be down here for you.
They can cut my hair.
There's no way at all tomorrow.
I can't. I have a manicure tomorrow. I have a pedicure tomorrow.
Yeah.
I have to work and I have to pack.
Yeah. I'm so sorry. Okay, let me check the book and see who
see
else
if
is
there's
available.
Somebody here that can cut my hair.
Yeah.
I can't.
My therapist, I told him there was a couple of times that I got choked up and that I didn't really, you know, I didn't want to cry so much. And he said to me, you better start crying, because if you don't start crying, you're going to kill somebody or you're going to have a heart attack. It's my dream to make the decisions and help people and make the calls, but, you know, you're always the bad guy, no matter what. Fuck, dude. God. Here we go. This kind of pressure, man. I'm surprised I made it this far. I'm so surprised I'm not in a mental institution. And I'm just opening a salon. I'm not, you know, taking over a country. You know what I mean? But it's all of this stuff, you know? You open a business in 3 weeks and hire everybody and the money and this and that. I'm not a billionaire. I only have what I have, you know? It's everything I got. So. Oh. I just don't want to be the bad guy. That's it. I don't want to be the monster.
So like patient, and I'm so like out of my mind. I think it's a good match. Are you the only wise brother? I'm like a crazy wild like motorcycle riding.
I like your tattoos.
Yeah, see, if you look closely, see her ass. She'll shake it for you. She's a good girl.
The whole world sounds like this to me right now. No matter what anybody's saying to me, it's like this. Tick 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 tick. If we don't pass inspection now, the party is off, and that will kill me.
So are you gonna be ready for tonight?
We hope so.
I hit a light switch, but there's not one in, is there?
No, but there will be. We need to put a cover plate up. There's an electrical switch box up here. And you said you got your handrails coming in. You got to wrap around.
Yep.
It looks like right now, you still got some work to do. What time do you plan on having your party? Is this party still a go? Is it not a go?
It is still a go.
Okay. We need to get some stuff buttoned up. We need to get this electrical buttoned up, plugs and switches in. We need to get this handrail up.
We'll do it.
Okay.
I'm good for it.
So I'll write up a tentative list on what we need to do right now, for what, just so you can have your party tonight.
Okay.
And then, but you won't be able to open until we resolve some of the other issues.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Hey Ralph, it's Kelly. How are you? I just wanted to give you a heads up that tonight the party's on. So I think we have two guys on for tonight for security.
What's going on? What's happening with the party?
As of right now, the party's still on.
It's still on? Great. I'm so happy.
How's everything over there?
It's coming.
The party's on for tonight.
Okay.
7:30.
I'm game.
Beverly Hills?
Cocktails, me?
There. The party's on for tonight.
It is?
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
What's up, man?
The party's on for tonight.
Yeah.
Today, I couldn't do anything. I was kind of paralyzed. I was completely immobile, you know? And Kim, Jen, and Jace, they came through, you know? They really did. Hooked me up to the lifeline of love. It's a good lesson there, you know? You can't do everything. And, you know, I did try to do everything on this job.
How do you think Jonathan is feeling today? I mean, overall, what do you think he's thinking right now? Do you think he'll be vacant? Like, just beyond exhausted? Just kind of like standing there like a prop, like.
Like you said I was earlier?
Yeah, exactly.
Amazing.
I can't even
believe,
the way
how
this
much
looks.
Stuff got done.
It's beyond fantastic. Take a look.
I can't even believe the same place. Ayumi! Hi!
Wow.
Wow. You look fantastic.
Pussycat dolls.
Pussycat dolls.
Are in the house.
Always understated.
Always.
Hello, girls.
Hello.
It's good to see you. Oh,
nice
thank you.
You.
No.
I love you.
It's kind of like the concrete is so modern, isn't it? It's cooler. This is like, it looks beautiful. Every color. You look so hot.
Hey, guys.
Perfect.
How are you? Moving. Very moving. You saw that Tish and Michael were here, right?
I briefly saw that.
Yeah, they kind of like visual acknowledgement barely and just kind of walked in. Not a whole lot more than that.
Where's everybody else at?
We're like the only ones here.
You're behaving right and you're treating people well and they don't reciprocate that. They're the ones who don't look right.
I just, you know, I flat out don't like the way she's been to people today. And I'll chalk it up to today, but we'll see. It was the first day.
Craziest thing I have ever been through in my life, ever. Here we go. It's setting in right about now, bro.
Press it down, go for it.
I'm so glad to see you. Woo, Jonathan.
How was today for you?
I don't know. It was, you know, I just roll with the punches.
Yeah, you do.
I don't let things get
to me. I heard you were screaming and kicking
That's
today.
That's not true. Oh.
That's all right.
No.
I love you. I'm sorry
I wasn't.
About today. It killed me.
It's no big deal.
All right, good.
I called you, but your voicemail was full.
It was full five different times.
I know.
How am I looking? Good right here? Right there? It's good lighting.
Does it feel like your wedding?
It's crazy. Hi.
Congratulations.
Hey, how are you? Good.
Hello.
Jonathan.
I'm Ross.
It's getting rumors starting. People are talking, Jeff. Your motorcycle entrance.
That's Brandon, someone else.
Oh, wow. Oh, my God. It looks great. Oh, yes. Full-length mirrors. That's so awesome.
She's the actress that's on the OC. She wants a hair consultation.
I'm wanting to go a little more chocolatey brown and maybe like a hair
cut. Great.
I'm a natural curly head.
When do you want to come in?
I don't know.
Well, I'm a good hairdresser. That's about as much as I can say.
It looks great. Do you know where you're going to be?
All I know is I want a full-length mirror. That's all I care about. I don't care where I am.
Wow. Looks good, brother, doesn't it?
I'm so happy to full-length mirrors. I love the full-length mirrors. Sorry I'm late. I was working late.
Hey, yeah.
That's what happens. I always work late.
Brandon Martinez.
I'm gonna go Jonathan Anton. How you doing, okay?
Yeah, I'm good.
Thank you.
So tell me about my hair. What are we gonna do?
Oh, God. I'm gonna hook you up.
Thursday.
She's coming in on Thursday.
She's gonna do my hair.
Oh, and she's massaging me right now. Right now, I will do whatever you want.
Okay, I have some ideas.
Oh, God. I'm so shy. Do those ideas involve my motorcycle, anybody, any chance?
You know what? I'm a little terrified of motorcycles.
Are you?
But to be honest, in the open road. We have to be in the open road.
But I ride an old antique. It's an antique motorcycle. It's Italian.
Okay, well, I'm Italian, so I can dig that.
It's like Ciao Bella.
Ciao Bella.
Ciao Bella, yeah.
What is it?
She was working it out, huh? Oh, I love that. The suit massage therapist are the best.
Tomorrow, I'm gonna be here at 7 a.m. All right? I kind of want you guys to be here by about 8 or 9, because we ain't done yet. Kim, come over here.
She's such a sweetie pie.
Yeah, she's been amazing.
Those two look so good today.
Thanks for coming, though.
Hey, no, it's always good fun, man.
Yeah. Toast? Are we gonna have a toast? All right, everybody.
Yay.
If I could please have all of your attention for 1 second. Look out. Tilt your glass, please. There you go. Just a dab. And last but certainly not least, right? There you go, buddy.
Speech.
First of all, I wanna start by saying thank you to all of you. Right? You're gonna get me.
Don't be a man, let it go.
All right, you pipe down. Have your drink. You all know that this is my dream, and I know this is all a dream for all of you as well. And just the fact that you're participating in my dream for me means more to me than anything in the world. And I just want to tell all of you I love you and wish all of us great luck. And
we love you.
Cheers. And tomorrow's our first day.
So
let's rock some hair.
Yeah.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Last night, the party was a total success, but there's one more hurdle. I need to pass final inspection today so I can open for business. I'm gonna pass inspection. If I have to finish it myself with my own hands, it's a done deal. Hi, Steph, it's Jonathan.
Hello.
Thank you very much for the flowers. It really, really means a lot to me.
Okay.
To feel the love from West Hollywood.
Okay, if anybody calls, it's definitely gonna be up and running at 2:00, is that correct?
We hope so.
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
Much better. Do I look like James Dean?
You look hot.
Hey, boss.
How you doing, man?
How you doing?
Good. Okay. You all right?
Yeah, how you doing?
Good. We're not ready for you to start unloading yet. You can put your bags in the back. Otherwise, they'll get up.
Okay.
All right?
Yeah.
All right, so wait, you guys, you can come in, but you pretty much have to stay in this area because we're still working back here and we're almost there. The clock's ticking and we're minutes away.
What do we have to do right now?
There's supposed to be a meeting from 11 to 12 and then from noon to 2 we're supposed to go do whatever we want and the salon opens at 2.
Nobody told me there was a meeting, so why do you think there's a meeting?
They told me on my voicemail, they left me a message. They said from 11 till noon there is a meeting. 2 o'clock is when the salon opens, okay?
What's the matter?
Just tons of misinformation all the time.
I know.
You just have to deal with it.
Wow, honey. It's nice to see you too.
Push. Good to see
push.
You.
Push.
Good to see you.
Push. You know what I'd love you to do? Find the plumber. Tell him these bowls gotta go in. He's gotta hurry up. There's no time for cigarette breaks. You know what I mean?
How mad is Alicia though right now? Is she looking mad or what? Is she looking like a happy camper?
I don't think so.
I love a cat fight.
I don't know.
Huh?
Can you read that?
Who is that?
Gracia.
She wanna come in?
I guess. She just said she wanted to speak.
Right.
Is there
right.
Hold on a second. Hi.
Can you just call her and book her?
Saturday?
Saturday, yeah.
Hey, bro, I've got them on 100 things. You gotta chill on the desk. Let them do
that.
I know, I heard what you said. I heard you. You just gotta hear me, okay? You gotta do it right now. It's all me. It's not you. You gotta let them do what they're doing.
All right,
okay.
All right, thank you. And you don't have to give me that either. All right?
Give me what?
That's not happening for me. Just blowing off what I'm saying. Just let my desk do what my desk needs to do. I'll deal with you in a little while.
You got it.
Here's the deal. The deal is that you gotta let me build the salon and finish it because it's not about you and your client. It's about me and the city of Beverly Hills right now. Otherwise, you're not gonna do anybody. And when I say that to you and you do this to me, whatever, dude. When you say whatever, to me, that's not cool. You said that, and that's not
cool. And I did say that, but they came out to me.
You can't say that to me, whatever. It's not about whatever, Brandon. It's not about you and your f***ing haircut. It's about the salon getting open.
You can relax.
No, no, no.
No one's getting in your face, man.
Don't tell me to relax, because you'll be out of here today. It's that simple.
Okay.
All right? You're doing it again. That's your childish
f***. No, no,
just
okay.
Letting you know.
Okay, no. Put my hands behind my back. I'm sorry.
No.
I don't know what I did wrong. I'm sorry.
I just want you to know you're that close already and you haven't even started, brother.
Are you all good?
Am I what?
Are you all good?
Oh, yeah. I'm totally good.
I thought you were. I just wanted to double check and make sure.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
I'm totally cool.
Okay.
Yeah, your boss is the one that's got I don't know what's his deal.
Okay.
Again, you know, the girls came to me and they just told me that I had somebody who wanted a book, so I freaked out on me, and I'm just like, okay, tough guy. I thought we were hairdressers, not tough guys.
Hold up, listen up. Everybody's gotta be out during the inspection. We don't have a certificate of occupancy yet, okay? So, everybody, go get something to eat. Keep your fingers crossed and say a prayer.
Do you wanna open today?
I wanna open today, brother.
Sure.
You know what? I brought you a jar of my best product.
No, thank you.
You gotta try. Look at your hair.
I'm fine with my hair.
I feel like I'm in high school for some reason. Like, I'm like the new cool kid. And like, you ever see Rebel Without a Cause where James Dean comes and he's new and no one likes him and then there's like the head guy and they wanna like test him? And that's how I feel. Like, I'm like, he wants to test me and like get in my face.
Because I was concerned about maybe having to use a wrap underneath the tailpiece.
The boot?
The boot. But if you're not gonna have that purpose.
I have boots.
Can you shake it a little more? That's hot. Oh my God, I love you.
Oh, yeah,
oh my God,
dude,
I love
you. That's the way we do it.
I love that. Oh.
Put it closer if you can. Okay. Basically, what you required is that it needs to be on the strike side.
You know, I got into hair, man, to have fun, man, and to like
That's
have a good time and say what the I want and have a blast.
File all this off, okay?
Yeah, we're sanding them all off. What do you want?
Just an iced tea, please.
A what?
Do you know if Jonathan smells alcohol in my breath? Like, it's not a good
thing. That's how I feel. That's why I'm like, I don't really
live on the edge, man. You know, you gotta like just dive right in.
No, I'm working right now.
Okay. Panel label?
Yep. Go ahead.
Yeah, he kind of did jump on you, and it wasn't called for, but.
I mean, come on, Kimberly, let's face it.
I think he's running on like 3 hours sleep, too.
Complete all your patchwork, all your painting, get all that stuff taken care of.
Thank you, sweetheart. Mwah.
You're okay to occupy. Start doing your thing, what you do.
you, right?
Thanks, brother.
All right, guys.
Appreciate it. That's what I want, man. Right now that you're having, the good news is they're all in your mind. Okay. Tish freaked out at Kim yesterday and she bullshit me and said she didn't do anything, and I know she did something, but it's all good because we're gonna deal with it, right?
Well,
Tish,
because
we're gonna deal with it, right?
Yeah, we are.
We're gonna deal with it.
Yeah.
Don't let anything affect you anymore.
Okay.
All right, good. Chill. We'll get there, okay?
All right.
Whoop. Sorry about that. How you doing?
Yeah.
Good?
I guess. I hope so.
I hope so too.
Let's just try it.
I got you covered. You know?
Okay.
You give me that message, I'll give it to him. I'll have that appointment booked like you couldn't imagine.
I know, but that's really all I did. I just gave
him
the message.
I know that's all you did. I
made sure that I stayed.
But right now, remember, right now, this much seems like this much. And it's not just you, it's all of us. We're all here together. All right?
Okay.
Thank you. All right. What we're gonna do right now is we're gonna assign chairs. This is where you're gonna do your thing and make your money and pay your bills, live half of your life. So, everybody take a deep breath.
Everybody thinks that they have to have the best spot and they have to, you know, be in the area that they want to. You know, their success depends on it.
Let's start with Daniel. Come on, baby. Let's make it happen. And I know there's no chair here and it's not ready yet. This is your space.
This is what I was telling Sarah. I was like, Sarah needs to be here and I need to be here.
And guess what?
Is that it?
No way.
That's so cool.
Sarah, come on down. Ayumi. Nice.
Yeah.
You have the break room right next to you. I have you between two beautiful women. Hang out. Take it all in, all right? Just stay out of the worker's way. Oh, Alicia. I hope you like it, all right? Remember that, you know, there's, you know, not a million spaces. You ready to see who's working next to you?
Yes.
I know. Here's where the hard part comes.
Am I in the back? Is that what you're sticking me? Hey, baby, yeah! Woo! I love it. Can I just say that I'm so happy that I have two mirrors so I can just be like, oh my God, oh my God.
He's abrasive to me. I don't dislike him as a person. Just working with him professionally, it's much different than, you know, how I am with my clients, and it kind of feels like it can be really annoying.
I'm gonna make you a lot of money, you're gonna make me a lot of money.
There you go.
Is that fair?
I love it. That sounds like a good deal. Here's your space, honey.
Yay, this is the one I wanted.
Is it?
Yes.
Here's your card.
I even came in this morning. Look, I manifested this. I came in and put my bag here.
I love you.
Thank you so much.
So I needed you right next to me because. Jason, you're right behind me. Stay tight.
Okay.
I need as much room as possible.
I've seen you work. You're like, bring it in a 747.
Glad to be by the door. It's really nice.
That way we can sneak out.
No chair for you yet.
Yes.
You gotta pass your tests. Yeah?
Yeah.
Here's your card. I love you. Thanks. We're open for business. When that phone rings, pick it up, answer it. Jonathan Salon, Beverly Hills.
Hey. How are you?
Nice to meet you.
I mean, there's some serious love here that I got this station.
How are you? You're gonna be my first client in this shop.
Hello, my dear. How crazy is it?
Look at her, she's beautiful. Look at that face, all right? Crying out loud. She's like 14 years old. I'm like an old man, you know?
The first haircut I did was Kate Bosworth's hair. We cut her right in the middle of the floor because there was construction going on everywhere. Insanity going on. I had my contractor run next door and grab me a mirror and a chair, and you know, it was nuts. So you're the first haircut since we've been open. Yes. See that? Yeah. It's not anywhere near uncommon for any one of our celebrities to just walk in with or without an appointment.
You ever lived in New York?
Yeah, I did.
Yeah?
How'd you know?
Oh, I have a lot of soap actor clients in New York, actually.
Yeah, I lived there for 5 years. That's where I got my soap start. So when did you come out here?
I come out here on a monthly basis, and I'm just back and forth.
So you're just bi-coastal.
Very bi-coastal, indeed.
Carlene, this is
Hi, how are you?
Today?
Nice to meet you. We just have to go through some of the makeup real quick, get everything kind of set up, and then...
She just did Britney Spears for her new video.
Wow.
Right?
Worked with Britney Spears.
That's awesome.
Yeah. She's good. All right, so I'm excited. Okay, I'll be back in a few minutes.
Look at this, this is good.
Smells really good.
Did you find the nude lip liner?
Yeah, it's right there.
Okay.
I think it would look really amazing if you took the back short.
All right,
so why don't we do that? But I want you to know, though, if I'm going to take you shorter through here and leaving you a little something in here, I don't want it to be like, you know, a convertible.
Exactly.
Yeah, like it needs to come up. No, it'll be cool.
Okay, all right.
It'll be cool.
Cool.
A little bit of a new gig.
Mm-hmm.
I like it. Handsome as ever.
All right.
Thanks, man.
Okay. Thank
awesome.
You.
Good?
Yeah, I love it. It's good.
I feel like my old assistant days. When I used to shampoo, I was a shampoo slut.
Man, you got some great hair.
Can I ask you something? Do your high school teachers try to hit on you?
No.
Jonathan, so if you can just sign this, it's for the birthday girl, Emily's client. We had to move around a couple times, and she got sent to West Hollywood in here. It's all mixed up.
They're doing something, because this is out of control.
Let's give her one of those flat irons, because I got a whole box of them for everybody, and we have some left over.
Sounds good.
Everybody here in Kimberly, we all felt really, really bad about what happened to you on Tuesday, and we found out it was your birthday.
Yeah.
We got you a little treat.
Oh, it's from us, from Jonathan and all of us.
Thank you so much for your patience and your understanding. It takes a lot to open up a shop.
No,
I'm so sorry that
And I realized that it was just like a shock when I walked in, and I'm like, wait, where am I? You know, like,
so. Lots of stuff in there.
Thank you for being so understanding. There's actually a little card in there too from Jonathan.
Yeah.
That is so sweet.
Yeah,
thank
happy
you.
Birthday.
Yeah,
thank
happy
you.
Birthday.
You're
welcome.
Hair looks beautiful.
Thank you.
Really nice.
They should be lucky that they're even breathing the same air. Boys like that. Boys like a challenge.
Personally, me, I'm really good one-on-one with people. But, you know, in a group situation, I don't always like to talk to a lot of people at once. I like to focus on one person at a time.
The ones coming from Jonathan Salon already were pretty tightly knit. It's got to be a weird situation to come into. Plus, I know she's not 100% happy. Also not willing to make a big deal out of her seating arrangement, but
right.
Isn't really happy about it.
High school, those were the days. So how are your grades?
I actually think Brandon's trying extra hard to stand out.
Absolutely.
It's a way to come into a new situation. It's not always the most comfortable.
But also making yourself stand out also isolates you as well. So sometimes that can have a positive effect, and then sometimes it can backfire in your face.
God, I got cold over in high school. Dropped out, actually.
You can sit there again if you'd like.
I'm leaving.
Avril Lavigne, who? Perfect. Don't talk to boys, because it's bad. Come on. All right, girl.
Thank
Work
you.
It out. Don't cause any car accidents outside, okay? Come on, Mom. Get over here. Let's work it out, girl.
I'm going to need one in 5 minutes.
All right, I'm totally trusting you. I'm, like, freaking out.
Why are you freaking?
I don't know.
Look at that.
I'm, like, slightly, connected. I want to kiss you, and the other half of me wants to just, like, throw you to the ground and smack you around a little bit.
I'll be fine with either one, to be honest.
This is my second salon. I have another one right down the street. Yeah, it's crazy. When I really figure that out, I'll be like, whoop, whoop, you know what I mean? I actually brought in American Express to help me figure out how to run two business. They have a new thing called American Express Open. Jen, what do you think about the whole Open network thing? Do you think it's going to be a great thing?
The business stuff?
Yeah.
Think
it's going to be a good thing?
Yeah.
I'm going to be late for my date tonight. I think that's your plan.
You need to stop that, man. That is so not fair. You and your dirty comments. I'm like a fragile angel.
I'm glad to be by Sarah.
So
where do you work?
I don't know. I mean, if I get a station, if I pass my test, somewhere, but it doesn't look like there's
any
space for me.
Maybe some of the
flyers. You think?
Maybe. It's not me.
I hope it's not me.
All right, Kim, blow her out.
Touch it, just one. Oh, God, stop it.
You should get insurance on that.
I should. I might not make it out alive.
Let me tell you, whatever you do, do not shave that, okay?
I promise.
No, that's nice. That's a nice amount of hair.
Touch it some more.
Oh, I like the little mole right
there. Isn't
that cute? Yeah.
I have a duck, too, right there. See?
So oh, is this bad? No. Okay, what's your color?
Honey, look at me for 1 second. Look good. Look at that. Here, shake it. Let's see it. Look at that. So hot. Awesome. Goodbye. Love
you. Thank you.
Can I ask you something? Is there any possibility I can go home?
Give me permission.
Washer and dryer will be here tomorrow at 11:30.
Okay.
We'll install the sink at some point tomorrow.
Okay.
The room will finish being painted. This will be done in the morning.
Get out of here.
I swear, I'm just gonna bite you right now. I'm just gonna, like, take a hold of you.
Seriously, don't leave a mark.
Bite you. No, I can't leave a mark because you got a date.
Thank you, everyone, for today.
Bye.
We made it happen. Thank you.
Anyway, thank
Enjoy.
You.
Enjoy. Bye, sweetheart.
I'll come in for the condition.
Okay, perfect. Take care, man. Nice meeting you.
Good meeting you, too.
Yeah, have a good night.
Thank you.
Enjoy your dinner.
Bye. Good night, you guys. Thank you.
Bye. Easy day's work. Do you guys want to go for a drink?
Well, what's the deal with Alicia? Did she quit?
No, she just doesn't have clients.
You can sit there again if you'd like. I'm leaving.
You need to complain if you're, like, slam busy. If you're slam busy and you're moving, like, 10 people a day, yeah, then I would complain. But, honey, you're not... I haven't seen you really work.
Like, what was going on with you? You had some drama of your own.
And we were talking. Jonathan caught the end of the conversation and kind of jumped to his own conclusions about the whole matter.
Yeah. So I went outside, and then he comes out, and he's, like yelling at me, like, you know, and you putting your hands up, you know, you're a wise ass. So I said, okay, fine, I'll put my hands behind my back, and I'll talk like this from now on. How about that? And he didn't, and he really didn't like that. And he's like, you're this close to getting fired.
Next on Blowout. Jonathan Beverly Hills is packing in the socialites and celebrities.
I'm Margaret.
I'm Jonathan.
You slap anybody?
Almost.
But are the stylists ready for their glamorous new neighborhood?
Look how big I am compared to you.
Don't take your shirts off in the salon ever again.
as Jonathan struggles to run two busy salons.
Your job is to do everything, not some things, everything.
It doesn't really matter so much what Jonathan thinks. Like, I'm just taking over it and I'm done.
Maybe some people are cool with it, I'm not.
If you're gonna do that, you should do it in the alley.
Tensions simmer. Will they reach the boiling point?
Why don't you get my back?